think about what other people are thinking, right? This is the dichotomy of like, I don't care what anybody else thinks, which is in some ways a really good attitude to have, and in some ways it's a really horrible attitude to have.
Mm-hmm.
Right? In some ways it's great to say, hey, you know what? I don't care what they think. Also, if you think that and you act like that, you're probably being seen by a bunch of people as someone that's looking out for themselves, as someone that's an egomaniac, as someone that they don't want to hang around with. Like, that's what's happening.
Yeah.
So how are we going to detach? I always talk about writing as a tool for detachment, because when you write things down, you are physically detached. You can see the words on the page now. But here's what I want you to write down. I want you to write down your intent when you're doing something. When you're going into a meeting, what's your intent? Your true intent. What is it? Write that thing down.
Yeah.
Write that thing down. And now, once you've written it down, imagine that you're walking into this meeting and you have that intent printed on your forehead.
Yep. It's a good one.
You might as well.
Yeah.
You might as well. Because if you go in there thinking that they're not going to know your intent, they're going to. Now, listen, they might not know your exact intent, but as we say, intent has a smell, and they're damn good, sure going to smell it. And they know it smells bad. You put some perfume over it, right? Put some, what's the cologne, if you're a dude, right? Put the cologne or the deodorant. Just put that on. You can mop that on there.
Yeah.
And people smell that, and they even still say, no.
Yeah.
When they put the little pine tree, right, in the taxi cab,
yeah.
You get in there, man, it still smells terrible. Yeah. Like, it smells pine needles and whatever else.
Funk.
Not good funk.
Yeah.
So you can try and cover it up, but you can't. So write down what your intent is. So you can detach from it, so you can see it. And once you see it, know this. That intent that you have, it flows into how you carry yourself. It flows into the way the words come out of your mouth. It's part of you. It's truly part of you, and you can't cover it up. And I've seen people that think they can do this. And it's the lack of self-awareness is horrible. You know, it's like you see someone that has... You ever heard a report from someone that's, I have a great relationship with that person?
Mm.
And the other person literally hates them.
Yeah.
That's how unaware they are.
Mm.
I have a great relationship with Fred. Fred hates me, despises me, and I think I have a great relationship. Mm. That's how bad it gets. So you got to be more suspect of yourself. You got to be more suspect of yourself. You don't sound as cool as you think you do. You don't sound as slick as you think you do,
mm-hmm.
by the way. You really don't. Right? I talk about Meryl Streep and Robert De Niro. You're not Meryl Streep. You're not Robert De Niro. You're not acting. You're not fooling anybody.
Sure.
You aren't that good at acting. Doesn't work.
Mm-hmm.
So if you sit down and you write down your intent, and your intent is bad, and if you would feel ashamed to walk into the meeting with your intent written on your t-shirt, hey, my goal in this meeting is to look good in front of the boss so I can get promoted. If that's what your intent is, and listen, everybody knows it. If that's what your intent is, you need to do some soul searching and change your intent. Your intent is bad.
Mm-hmm.
Your intent is bad. You should change your intent to, okay, I am going to help with the mission. I'm going to put the team first. That's my intent. Now, this is where people get messed up. They get jammed up.
Jammed up.
Is I think, well, but I really want to get promoted. Okay, so you walk into that meeting with that intent, and guess what? Everyone can see it. No one wants to work with you. Your boss thinks you're an ass kisser. It's all bad. If you change your intent, you go, you know what? Okay, I don't care about getting promoted. What I want to do is help the team, put the team first, and accomplish the mission. Imagine you walk in with that on your shirt, and the other teammates go, I put the team first. They see that. They smell it. They go, right on. The boss smells, oh, Jocko really cares about the team. Oh, okay, he really wants to get the mission done. Okay. They smell that. Now they get a positive impression. Now they're like, oh, we want to help. The rest of the team's like, yeah, we want to help you too. You know what you end up doing? You end up getting promoted.
Mm-hmm.
That's the byproduct.
Yeah.
That's the byproduct of what's going on.